Whoop, motherfucking whoop, fam. So I mentioned on here before that Insane Clown Posse is not the worst band in the world. I've also mentioned that even though they're not taken seriously by most people, this music is some of the deepest music I've ever heard. I'm gonna show you why. And this is just one of many reasons why I say that. Some would say this is like Christian rap. Kinda. But watch this though. So that whole scene, see, these guys may not be like the best delivery type of rappers, but they sure are storytellers, man. I'll tell you that much. That whole scene they just rapped was basically like when you die, you go down this hallway and you're strapped in this chair. This is what happens after death, right? And then they start seeing these visions. So let's keep going. See where this takes us. You see what they did right there? They basically, you know, somebody died. They walk down this hall. They basically get nabbed, slapped into it, you know, strapped down into a chair. And they see this vision. And when they're rapping it, they paint this picture, right? The vision the guy is seeing is of a happy family, right? Two kids, they playing Nintendo. You know, the wife is in the chair smiling. And then he snaps out of it, boom, and he starts and he realizes what his real life was. He was a fucking drunk piece of shit beating his wife and kids. And mind you, this is a person that just died. Like, that's some deep shit right there. Like, is this basically like, where's this dude gonna go now? Think about that for a minute. Here, I'm gonna even rewind it and let you hear it again. Can't see straight from getting hit. You noticed part two, you know, dude, another dude dies, boom, walks through that same hallway, sees all that blood from the last dude that died. You know, until 2002, Juggalos didn't even know what this shit meant. This shit is crazy. Like, I'm gonna get more into it in future episodes on other songs and what this whole thing really is about for, you know, for viewers that are looking at Juggalos like, what the fuck is wrong with them, right? Kind of give you a better understanding of it. And also for these newcomers, you know, that might not have heard some of these, or might not even understand themselves what this music really represents. Catch that? Is it, hey, this scene is painted, right, of a nice life, man, you know, perfect life. And he goes, is it true, have you really seen the Holy Ghost? Hell nah, bitch, not even close. I mean, this is like, look, I understand it's not like praise Jesus type of stuff, right? But you got to admit, there's like a there's like a underlying warning of hell in these lyrics. And it's not just this song. Here, let me finish this up real quick. Watch your step to hell. It's a long fall. You know, some of my viewers probably aren't religious, don't believe in God, maybe. But I know a lot of people still do. And that was deep, man. I mean, so there's a lot of this type of stuff in the music. There's a lot of moralistic events, you know, in this music, and they get out their frustrations about this by rapping about killing these people. you know, killing the guys, beating his wife, beating his kids. He kills him, and the guy goes to hell. So when you listen to this shit a lot, you kind of adopt those policies, you know, those same, you know, if you're not doing those type of things to people, if you're not living like a wicked life like that, you're going to feel that what they rapping about these people doing is wrong. Like, you're going to feel that is wrong inside. You know what I'm saying? You're going to be like, psh, beating your kids and your wife? Come on, that's lame as fuck, man. So this is the shit I was talking about. Juggalos being misunderstood, looked at as different. The rest of the world is missing out. I think that's... Anti-bigotry. You kind of see a common theme here. You know, like I said, I'm going to get into other songs, but it's not, because it's not just this one. Like, countless songs. Countless. I thought that was pretty creative, man. They told a story. Like, they painted a picture. You know what I'm saying? And that's why we love this type of music. Like, they may not be the best in delivery, but they paint a picture like nobody I've ever seen. This music is different. You know, a lot of rap, you know, I like a lot of different rap. Most of it I don't like. A lot of it's the same. I can tell you right now, ain't nobody doing shit like this. Look, then, you know, for people old enough to remember CDs, you know, they had these booklets, right? And in each booklet would be, you know, a little explanation on what it is. So this album, so this song is called Halls of Illusions. It's off the Great Malenko album by Insane Clown Posse. And the thing in the booklet, it goes... And so like they kind of put like a, you know, this might sound weird to some people. They kind of put like a spiritual theme, or maybe not spiritual, but more like a more like a supernatural theme around these around these albums, right? So it says, from deep within the Netherlands of Shadow Walkers comes yet another exhibit of the Dark Carnival. He is the master of the art of using magic without magic. He is a necromancer. I know all this shit probably sounds weird to the average person, but please just bear with me, because it gets to a point. It has a point to it. He is a necromancer, the craft of using magic through the dead. Dead meaning both physically and mentally. This spectacle shall be witnessed only by those who are meant to see it. Look deep inside of your soul and ask yourself. You see this theme? Look deep inside your soul and ask yourself. Do you hold a ticket to witness the show? The answer lies within yourself. He is the fourth to rise. He feeds upon one's own greed. I know it's a lot of greedy people out there, man, that would like to get somebody else's come up. So it says, he is the fourth to rise. He feeds upon one's own greed. He is powered by one's own jealousy, lust, and temptation. To envision yourself with something that rightfully does not belong to you, that is the illusion cast by him. That's deep, man. Think about this stuff. To act upon this vision and seek it out at the expense of another, that is the magic cast by him. At the expense of another, man. Continuous dreamers of profit at the cost of another are pledged and haunted by his wizardry. So, you know, this is like all a metaphor, right? This is like some clown that like cast this illusion to you, you know, that greed is okay, that you want to get this by any means necessary, right? So I'm almost done here. Where was I? Others are, okay. Continuous dreamers of profit at the cost of another are pledged and haunted by his wizardry. Others are content and satisfied with what they can achieve by themselves and have not the urge to tamper with another's well-being for quick gain. They see him only as a hoax and see no illusions or magic by he. It is simple. He is you. His illusions are your evil thoughts. Your evil acts are his magic. Yesterday, now, and forever. You and he are the fourth to rise. You and he are the master of necromancy. You the dead, and him the magic. Together, you and he are the great Malenko. So, most Christians would call that a demon, right? I mean, technically, you can consider this type of stuff a religion. Honestly, like, I look at it as more of like a metaphorical religion. Like, basically what he's talking about is a demon that casts illusions on people, that it's okay to get, you know, to come up by any means necessary. It's okay to put three people through hardship so you can have financial gain, right? That's basically what they're saying in both the booklet and in this song right here. You know what I'm saying? You kind of see the connection between that and this song about people going to hell for their wicked ways. Like I said, this is just one song out of, what, 57 albums. Stay tuned. West Coast, and I'm out.